Good afternoon. We welcome each of you to St. Peter's, especially if you're a guest. We welcome you. We ask that everyone please sign the card in the pew. If you either put that in the offering plate or hand it to us on the way out, greatly appreciate it. This weekend, as you see with all the quilts, it is LWML, Lutheran Women's Missionary League weekend. And so we celebrate the mission and give thanks for the work that of the Lord. As well, if you go on to the next one, it is also the 17th Sunday after Pentecost, and our theme is For Us and With Us. But before we begin our service, would you do me a favor? Would you rise and turn around and say hello and God's peace to those around you? God's peace. God's peace. God's peace. Thanks for sitting up close. God's peace. God's peace up there. Our opening hymn is Christ is our cornerstone. You can follow along in the hymns either on the screen or it's 912 in the hymnal. May God bless our worship. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. We take a moment of silence for reflection. Let us then confess our sins to God our Father. Most merciful God, we confess that we are by nature sinful and unclean. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We justly deserve your present and eternal punishment. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us, forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Upon this, your confession, I, by virtue of my office as a called and ordained servant of the word, announce the grace of God unto all of you, and in this stead, by the command of my Lord Jesus Christ, I forgive you all your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come into his presence with singing. Know that the Lord, he is God. It is he who made us, and we are his. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him. Bless his name. For the Lord is good. His steadfast love endures forever, and his faithfulness to all generations. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. In peace, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For the peace from above, and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For this holy house and for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord. Amen. You may be seated as we sing, Joyful, Joyful, We Adore Thee. Lord, be with you. Let us pray together the prayer of the day. We pray. O God, you did not spare your own Son, but gave him up for us all. Grant that by faith we may trust in your promises and live according to your will. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Please be seated for our readings. Our Old Testament reading is from Habakkuk the prophet, chapters 1 and 2. The oracle that Habakkuk the prophet saw. O Lord, how long shall I cry for help, and you will not hear, or cry to you violence, and you will not say? Why do you make me see iniquity, and why do you idly look at wrong? Destruction and violence are before me. Strife and contention arise. So the law is paralyzed, and justice never goes forth. For the wicked surround the righteous, so justice goes forth perverted. I will take my stand at my watchpost and station myself on the tower. and look out to see what he will say to me and what I will answer concerning my complaint. And the Lord answered me, write the vision, make it plain on tablets, so he may run who reads it. For still the vision awaits its appointed time. It hastens to the end. It will not lie. If it seems slow, wait for it. It will surely come. It will not delay. Behold, his soul is puffed up. It is not upright within him. But the righteous shall live by his faith. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. We read selected verses of Psalm 90 responsively. Lord, you have been our dwelling place in all generations. Before the mountains were brought forth, wherever you had formed the earth and the world, from everlasting to everlasting, you are God. You return man to dust and say, return, O children of man. For 1,000 years in your sight are but as yesterday when it is past, or as a watch in the night. The years of our life are 70, or even by reason of strength 80. Yet their span is but toil and trouble. They are soon gone, and we fly away. Who considers the power of your anger and your wrath according to the fear of you? So teach us to number our days, that we may get a heart of wisdom. Our epistle reading and also our text for tonight's message is from Romans chapter 8, beginning with the 31st verse. What then shall we say to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own son, but gave him up for us all, how will he not also with him graciously give us all things? Who shall bring any charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is to condemn? Christ Jesus, the one who died, more than that, who was raised, and who is at the right hand of God, who indeed is interceding for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or danger, or sword? As it is written, for your sake we are being killed all the day long. We are regarded as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am sure that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. As you're able, we rise for the reading of the Holy Gospel. The Holy Gospel is according to St. Luke, the 17th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said to his disciples, temptations to sin are sure to come, but woe to the one through whom they come. It would be better for him if a millstone were hung around his neck and he were cast into the sea than that he should cause one of these little ones to sin. Pay attention to yourselves. If your brother sins, rebuke him. And if he repents, forgive him. And if he sins against you 7 times in the day and turns to you 7 times saying, I repent, you must forgive him. The apostles said to the Lord, increase our faith. And the Lord said, if you had faith like a grain of mustard seed, you could say to this mulberry tree, be uprooted and planted in the sea, and it would obey you. Will any one of you who has a servant plowing or keeping sheep say to him when he has come in from the field, come at once and recline at table? Will he not rather say to him, prepare supper for me and dress properly and serve me while I eat and drink? and afterward you will eat and drink. Does he thank the servant because he did what he was commanded? So you also, when you have done all that you were commanded, say, we are unworthy servants. We have only done what was our duty. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. We confess our faith according to the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Congregation may be seated. I invite any children who'd like to come forward for a message to do so at this time. Come out to you, since we are all children of God through faith in Jesus. Good to be with you guys tonight. How's everybody doing?
Good.
Got to be doing good on a wonderful day, a beautiful day. And I know it would have been nice to have an outdoor service, but we'll just give thanks for being together. All right, what do I got in my hand? Any football fans here? Come on. All right, we got a few football fans here. This is, at least to me, a special football. What does this say on it? Can you read that for me? Minnesota Vikings, you like that? I like that. Yeah, not so much. You know, I have to say, when it comes to football, do you know what the Minnesota Vikings are known to do? Choke. They are one of the few teams that have made championships but have not won. I've got some colors on me. It's not my favorite colors. It may remind you of another team that actually has won a championship or two along the way, hasn't they? Yeah. Don't count them for good for them. Teams today was pretty rough, wasn't it? Minnesota lost and Wisconsin lost. But Friday, guess who won? The Beavers won. Yeah, against a big rival, against Bearville, right? We give thanks. Well, and hopefully there weren't injuries along the way. When I'm thinking of championships, I think of our reading for today, and it spoke about us being more or greater, overwhelmingly conquerors or winners. And it has nothing to do with football or any other sport or even anything about you and me, but it is for us. And it speaks about us being overwhelmingly conquerors. Now, what's it referring to? Anybody know? Sin, death, and the power of the devil. We are overwhelming conquerors through him who loved us, and that one who loved us is Jesus. And he won victory in an amazing way, not that we would think. It actually came through his death on the cross, didn't it? When he died our death to pay for our sin. And then amazingly, on the third day, he rose from the grave, conquering sin, death, and the power of the devil. And on a special day, maybe it occurred here or maybe somewhere else, in your baptism, God made you his own and gave you that victory. So that, you know what? Now there's nothing that we need fear. Not sin, not death, not the power of the devil, because it's all been won through Jesus. And that's something we can ever give thanks. Notice it's in him and through him, not in us, but given to us by his mercy and love. Now that's a message we need to know, especially in a world where all sorts of stuff is going on. We have something better to look forward to, our heavenly home through faith in Jesus. And may we keep our eyes on that and share that good news with the world. Do me a favor, would you bow your heads and fold your hands? Let's pray. We pray. Dear Jesus, we thank you and praise you. We thank you that you've won victory and that we too are victorious. We overwhelmingly conquer through you, more than conquerors. Thank you for setting us free, not that we can do what we want, but be whom you've made us to be, your light. Keep us firm in that love and faith. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We sing our sermon hymn, which is How Firm a Foundation, 728. God's grace and peace be multiplied unto each of you tonight from God our Father and from our risen Savior Jesus. Amen. Our text, as mentioned, is from Romans chapter 8. I believe we have verse 31 of chapter 8 up there. Would you read it with me? If God is for us, who can be against us? Please pray with me. We pray. Gracious Heavenly Father, we pray that you be with us as we come to your house to hear your word and receive your gifts. We give thanks for the privilege of knowing the good news of your love. Keep us firm in that faith and help us to share that good news with the world around us. I pray now that the words of my mouth in the meditation of my heart. May it ever be pleasing and acceptable in your sight, O God, our rock and our redeemer. In Jesus, our Savior's name, we pray. Amen. Beloved in the Lord Jesus Christ, there is something very powerful, almost even, I don't know if you want to call it sacred, about holding someone else's hand. Would you go on to the next slide for me? Beautiful picture, isn't it? Of a parent, perhaps a father or a mother, holding the hand of a little one, a baby. Oh, what a precious sight. Be able to hold that beautiful creation and to be able to grab on and to hold them tight. Wish they would stay that age, though. They grow up too fast, don't they? How about we go to the next one? I thought I'd show you a few more pictures. In top left, picture of like a teacher or a parent. I don't know if you remember bringing your child to kindergarten or preschool for the first time for school and holding that child's hand and even seeing looks like an older sibling holding the hand of their younger sibling. Or, well, top right is supposed to be a picture of like a competitor falling and a brave teenager having the motivation and love to be able to reach down and to grab hold of the person and pick them up as they're down on the ground, even a smile, which we give thanks for. Or bottom left picture, for those of you who are a little bit older, you remember your first love and your first time and first holding hands with a boyfriend or a girlfriend. And I must say, the first time that happened, I had that, I don't know if you guys had the sweaty hand thing going on, and you know, however it may be. But that's a precious memory, isn't it? Or here's an older couple. I'm trying to remember the name of the family, the couple that was just down the block when I first came here. I can picture them, I can't think of their name, but they would, when they came to church, they would walk up the sidewalk, and they'd be holding hands all the way as they came to church. And we see that too today, don't we? A people, the elderly holding one another's hand. And how precious that is to see that love that's been there for so long and we give thanks and praise to God for. How about the next one? To the left, that was another day I was sweating a little bit. Wedding day, holding hands there before the altar of God and before the pastor. I don't know if you remember that. I was kind of shaking a little bit. I don't know about you, but those are days and powerful to hold the hand of your spouse. And this one's a little tougher. I could have put up another picture. It was of my mother-in-law holding the hands of my father-in-law. And that was actually 2 years ago. It was a memoriam. Was a picture of their hands holding. She wouldn't let go of his hands as he was waiting for the Lord to call him home, and did through faith in Jesus. And you can see that here, how precious that is and how much that means to be there and to have someone there in that time of need. Would you go on to the next one? Holding hands like that, it's important, that touch. It's important not to let go. Perhaps you remember a time like us. I remember when our boys are younger, we went to Disney World, and I remember it was getting later, and you know, at Disney World, at the main Disney World, I'm trying to remember what it's called, but by the castles, you come around. I remember with our three boys, they were younger, coming around and looking, and there was just a sea of people. And we wanted to get to the other side, to get out, and we wanted to watch the fireworks, not from there because of the crowd, but we wanted to watch it a little less congested. And when we went through there, I was holding on to the stroller, I recall, and Nathan was about, 13, Brandon a couple years younger, and boy, holding on to one another, trying not to lose one another in that sea of crowd to get to the other side. Or maybe you've been on a hike or somewhere where the mountains and hiking and with your children, and you just were holding on, and you told them, you hold on with all your might as we go, and you're thankful with that good grip to maintain it. It was important to stay together and to be safe, wasn't it? This weekend, as I mentioned, is LWML weekend, Lutheran Women's Missionary League. They're an organization, auxiliary organization of our church, the LCMS, in which they sponsor mission efforts to reach out with the love of God to people. They do that with their mites, and they do it with offerings that together help more people hear about the good news of Jesus, our Savior. And they've done this for decades, proclaiming the strong witness of a God who loves and holds on to each of us. But they're not the only ones called to share that message, are they? We too are called to know it and to share that message. And so our text for this weekend, the epistle, I'd like to consider two questions that the Apostle Paul brings up. First of all, he says, what then shall we say to these things? If God is for us, we read, who can be against us? Now, it's important to mention that the main subject is God. If God is for us, who can be against us? It's kind of like the portion of scripture in the same book that says, I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. And we like to focus on us, but the focus is actually on Him who gives us strength. But clearly, sometimes we forget that, don't we? All of us, including myself. Sometimes we think that we can make it on our own, that we are self-sufficient. And sometimes we think that life and success or whatever depends upon us or our work or our efforts or our talents. And that can be kind of a slippery slope, subtle. Thoughts of self-dependence or thinking ourselves more highly than ourselves or we ought can open a door to believing that we are the focus of the world and the kingdom and of God's love. But the Apostle Paul, by the power of the Holy Spirit, gives a different picture. He makes it quite clear that it's God's everlasting love that holds us, that keeps us. And when we are insufficient, He is sufficient in all circumstances. When we are faithless, you and I, He is ever faithful. Thanks be to God. I remember one of our former pastors, Pastor Quill, and his wife Peg, they would often say, it's all God. And he and they were right. Through creation, through redemption, being saved, and even keeping in the faith, it's all God. And thanks be to God, He is faithful for us and for all. And because Jesus is for us and with us, our text tells us we need not fear condemnation, the day of judgment, or standing before the Lord. Paul writes this, what shall we say then to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own son, being the heavenly Father, but gave him up for us all, how will he not also along with him graciously give us all things that we need? And what things? Paul acknowledged that our salvation is all God. Therefore, may we respond in thankfulness that God is for us. And since God is for us, we have nothing to fear. Paul continues when he says these words, who shall bring any charge against those whom God has chosen? It is God who justifies. Who is he that condemns? Christ Jesus, who died, and more than that, who is raised to life and is at the right hand of God as interceding for us. It is Jesus who died in our place, our death on the cross for all of our sins, and raised victorious because God, the Heavenly Father, accepted his payment for our sin. The bill was paid in full. The check was cleared. Thanks be to God, it didn't bounce, and it wasn't found with insufficient funds. He died once for all so that we might live now and eternally through him and him alone. And now Jesus is interceding for us. He speaks in our defense, in our behalf, fully engaged in battle for us, with us. Or as Corrie ten Boom put it, there is no pit so deep that God's love is not deeper still. And how true that is. And think about that in your life, in my life, all the pits that we've gone through. Sometimes from circumstances and trials and difficulties, and sometimes because of our life, the things that we've done and said and left undone. Our past that can even plague us to this day as we look at our own selves and our own life. None of us, even this day, has lived a perfect day. And how many regrets that you and I have in life? Me too. And the law convicts us because the law shows exactly where we have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. The pit is pretty deep for all of us. But God's love is still deeper and reaches. His long arm, his love, is able to rescue all, including you and me. And his stretched out arms on the cross of Calvary did rescue us. And brought rescue for our world. Those same arms were made alive as Jesus rose from the grave victorious. Jesus is for us and with us. Even though Satan wants to accuse and condemn, the action of Jesus is evident. The victory is complete, and the result is clear. No condemnation for those in Christ Jesus. Which means you and me and all in our Lord. We too are called to share the good news of that message, the good news of the gospel. Just like the LWML has, we too. And the Holy Spirit is at work as the word is proclaimed, the good news of Jesus. God, the Holy Spirit, worked through us too as we share the message. And so that leads to the next point of our text. Because Jesus is for us and with us, we have no fear of separation. In your mind, picture those hands again, holding on to one another. God will never let go of you or me or our hands or of us. And that's what Paul says in Romans 8. He says this, who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or danger or sword? As it is written, for your sake we are being killed all the day. We are regarded as sheep to be slaughtered. No. In all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. Notice what Paul does not say in this text. He does not say that our lives will be free of challenges or difficult circumstances. He does not say that we'll not have distress or danger, that it won't happen. It will in this world. In fact, he writes in great detail elsewhere what he went through as he followed the Lord, the Apostle Paul, and his experience and his challenges. And we know this from our life too, in our experiences. Each of us could make a list of struggles, personal or family, friends. All of us have struggles in this broken world. But God declares you righteous and me too, and has loved us with an everlasting love in Jesus. And our assurance comes from the love of God in Christ Jesus, our risen Lord. With no fear of condemnation or separation, we come to the last part. Because Jesus is for us and with us, we have certainty of victory. The victory is ours, and it's made ours personal in our baptism as he's applied to us what he won for us on the cross: forgiveness, life, and salvation. Romans 6, verse 4 says this: we were buried, therefore, with him by baptism into death. We died to sin. In order that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might walk in newness of life. Our baptism means victory. Victory through Christ over our sin, over death, and the power of the devil. We are more than conquerors through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Our victory is not secure because of our hold on Jesus, but his hold on us. We are more than conquerors because he holds us tightly to himself. Therefore, we live each day, including today, confidently in our Lord. And as baptized children, we remain in his word, reminded of who we are and whose we are. We rely on his grace through his word and sacrament. And by grace through faith, we respond to his call. Like Isaiah the prophet, may we too say, here am I, send me. Thanks be to God. He holds us close to him. And may we reach out with his love to all with his love, that many more may be held in his mercy and grace, today and forever. Amen. May the peace of God, which passes all human understanding, keep our hearts and minds in the true faith unto life everlasting, through Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. Amen. We continue at this time as we sing our offertory hymn, verses 1 and 5, and the offering is brought here. Rise as we speak the pledge for the LWML and also for our prayers. In fervent gratitude for his Savior's dying love and his blood-bought gift of redemption, we dedicate ourselves to him with all that we are and have. And in obedience to his call for workers in the harvest fields, we pledge our willing service wherever and whenever he has need of us. We consecrate to our Savior our hands to work for him, our feet to go on his errands, our voice to sing his praises, our lips to proclaim his redeeming love, our silver and our gold to extend his kingdom, our will to do his will, and every power of our life to the great task of bringing the lost and the erring into eternal fellowship with him. Amen. Almighty God, we give thanks for your goodness and love in Christ that sustains us each day. We praise you for the gift of your Son, Jesus Christ, who is for us and with us in all things. We thank you for the Holy Spirit, our comforter and sustainer of faith. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Guide, we pray, our congregation and our life together and witness in the world. Grant us your grace and strengthen your people through the word and the sacraments. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For the mission of the Lutheran Women's Missionary League in this congregation and throughout the world, that each person involved would see opportunities to be salt and light to their neighbors and through various opportunities for mission. Through the faithful gathering of mites, may Lutheran Women in Mission continue to encourage us to put all you have given us into the mission of reaching the lost. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Sanctify our homes with your presence, reminding us that nothing can separate us from your love. Unite the members of all families in love toward you and each other. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Almighty God, we pray that you remember all pastors, church workers, teachers, missionaries, as well as Sunday school teachers who serve you and your people. Embolden them in their witness and teaching that your love may be made known to all. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. O Lord, bless the upcoming voters meeting and the calling of a DCE, that you might lead us to know whom you have chosen to serve here at St. Peter's. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Holy God, strengthen those whom you have placed in authority in the government, that they may govern wisely, and that we might live free of strife and contention. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of all grace, remember those who suffer from violence, strife, illness, affliction, or tragedy, especially those affected by Hurricane Ian, as well as the people in the Ukraine and other areas of trial in our country and throughout the world. We also remember those in need of your healing hand and blessing and strength. We remember Jean Salas, David Luther, Carl Cook, Kathy Jones, Gary Schultz from Janesville, Sandy and Ken Rosensky, Crystal Olnick, Cheryl Arkin, Logan Nesset, Connie Zimmerman, Sherry Neely, and those we name in our hearts. Heal and deliver them according to your will, and when your answer seems slow, strengthen them by Christ's righteousness to await your timing and live by faith. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Comfort all who mourn with your presence and peace, and assure all who are in Christ of the reunion and resurrection that is ours and our loved ones through faith in Jesus Christ. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray. Trust in your mercy for the sake of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated as we sing, In Thee is Gladness.
Given the gifts of heaven, thou the true.
receive the blessing of the Lord. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with his favor and grant you his peace. Amen. We sing our closing hymn, Serve the Lord with Gladness. Once again, good afternoon, and welcome to each of you, especially if you're a guest. Please come and join us again anytime for worship at St. Peter's. I just was asked to announce from the LWML that the quilts in the pew that were made by loving hands go out to Orphan Grain Train and also the Children's Hospital. And we give thanks for that. We also remember and give thanks for the mission grants that are given. And I'll refer you to the mic boxes are in the back and refer you to the insert with more information about that wonderful ministry. We give thanks and pray the Lord's continued blessing. Also, next week is Mission Weekend as well, as LAMP, Lutheran Association of Missionaries and Pilots. Reverend Shabe, the executive director for LAMP, will be our speaker, and I'll be the liturgist, but it's been 2 years now. They were not able to come, and we give thanks that they're able to come, and we hopefully look forward to having another mission trip of our own next year going forward. And so that will be going on next week. We have our voters meeting that is coming up on Wednesday for the calling of a DCE. There's information. We have two DCEs now that will be considered. One asked to take his name off because the pastor there recently received a call. There is also information on how we can encourage with Hurricane Ian and with the storms on the back. It was a slide also, and also teams to go forward. So that's on there back with also the information on the candidates. And we have Sunday school tomorrow, a lot of wonderful other things going on. Have a very blessed evening. The Lord be with you, and Lord bless your week.